नेक्स्ट वी डिफाइन द क्रिटिकल रीजन, ए रीजन कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग टू स्टैटिस्टिक्स इन द सैम्पल स्पेस एस विच अमाउंट टू रिजेक्शन द नल हाइपोथेसिस एच नॉट इज कॉल्ड द क्रिटिकल रीजन और रीजन ऑफ रिजेक्शन. द रीजन ऑफ द सैम्पल स्पेस एस विच अमाउंट ऑफ द एक्सेप्टेंस एच नॉट इज कॉल्ड एक्सेप्टेंस रीजन. इन दिस दीज आर द टू टेल टेस्ट एंड दिस डार्क पोर्शन इज द क्रिटिकल रीजन एंड दिस इज द वन टेल टेस्ट एंड राइट टेल टेस्ट एंड दिस डार्क पोर्शन इज कॉल्ड द क्रिटिकल रीजन. इन दिस ग्राफ दिस इज द क्रिटिकल रीजन एंड लेफ्ट टेल टेस्ट. इफ म्यू इज इक्वल टू म्यू नोट, म्यू इज इक्वल टू म्यू नोट वी डिस्कस अबाउट इन टेस्ट ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस. दिस दैट मीन टू टेल टेस्ट. इफ म्यू इज लेस देन म्यू नोट देन लेफ्ट टेल्ड. If mu is greater than mu naught, then we say that this is right tail test. These are both are the single tail test and these are the two tail test. That means there are critical region lie in two sides, in this one side. So we say that one tail test. In also in this figure is one tail. So this is the critical region. So critical region is denoted by H naught is acceptance or rejection. So rejection region is called the critical region. Now level of significance, that mean we say that level of significance, in generally we say that we have to purchase wheat for any other purpose excepting eating the food. We can use for the any other option to grow in the. So we donate the to stores and so level of significance. Generally, if we want to purchase the wheat to for birds, and we cannot assume that the quality of wheat is 100% right. We can accept the quality is 90% good. So this is the level of significance. How percentage of the wheat is good? Good quality wheat. So this is the represent the quality of wheat is level of significance. 5%, 10%, 50%, 90%. How many percent wheat quality I want? This is called the level of significance. This level of significance define the boundary of critical region also. In this figure, we can say that this is the boundary of critical region and we said that this is the level of significance. This is the level of significance. These are the dark portion and these are the acceptance region and these are the rejection region. The boundary of the acceptance and rejection region is called the level of significance. At which level we want to check the sample error. After that, assuming the sampling, there are two type of error contained in this sampling theory. So first error is if H naught is true and we may reject it. That means these are the producer risk. H naught is true, that means a definite statement in favor of sample is true, but any region, any effect, any results give us to a statement true or we reject the null hypothesis. That means this is the producer risk. Producers make the quality of own things, objects is good, but it not sell out. This is the producer risk. Type 2 error. Type 2 error, H naught is wrong and we accept it. That means this is the consumer risk. So we give example of this type 1 and type 2 error. If we want to purchase the wheat of 10 quintals, if I said that to shopkeeper, that mean ki is jagah se mere ko sample dikhaiye aur us sample ko dekh ke jahan se usne sample dikhaya wahi sample kharab tha aur baki complete lot uska theek tha aur us sample ke behalf pe main us complete lot ko reject kar deta hu. That mean this is the producer risk. प्रोड्यूसर ने सारी चीज़ सही बनाई, सही अच्छे तरीके से रखी, बट सैंपल की वजह से, जो सैंपल ऑब्जर्वेशन थी उसके बिहाफ पे मैंने कहा कि भी मैं इस गेहूं को नहीं खरीद सकता. दिस इज़ द बैड क्वालिटी. सो ओनली जो हमने सैंपल लिया वहीं जगह पे उसी जगह पे ख़राब गेहूँ था और बाकी कंप्लीट लोड ठीक था. दैट मीन टाइप वन एरर, दिस इज़ कॉल्ड द प्रोड्यूसर रिस्क. सेकेंड एरर, दैट मीन जिस जगह से मैंने व्हीट को लिया वही ठीक था और बाकी कंप्लीट लोड ख़राब था और मैंने उसको परचेज कर लिया. दैट मीन दीज आर द कंज्यूमर रिस्क. सो देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ एरर इन सैम्पलिंग. फर्स्ट वन इज़ टाइप वन एरर, टाइप टू एरर. टाइप वन एरर इज व्हेन एच नोट इज़ ट्रू एंड वी रिजेक्ट इट. सेकेंड वन व्हेन एच नोट इज़ रॉन्ग एंड वी एक्सेप्ट इट एंड वी एक्सेप्ट एच वन. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड द प्रोड्यूसर रिस्क एंड कंज्यूमर रिस्क एंड बोथ एरर आर प्रोपोर्शनल टू ईच अदर. दिस बोथ क्रिटिकल वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंट वैल्यू. द क्रिटिकल रीजन एंड सिग्निफिकेंट आर डिसाइड इन डिफाइन इन दिस बोथ इन द गिवन फिगर्स. दीज आर द क्रिटिकल रीजन और एक्सेप्टेंस रीजन. टू टेल टेस्ट, वन टेल टेस्ट. दिस इज लेफ्ट टेल, दिस इज राइट टेल. दीज बोथ आर द सिंगल टेल टेस्ट एंड दिस वन इज द टू टेल टेस्ट. सो नेक्स्ट, नाउ टेस्ट ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस फॉर लार्ज सैंपल. सो वी यूज द टेस्ट ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस फॉर लार्ज सैंपल. दैट मीन इफ द सैंपल यूनिट इज ग्रेटर देन 30, दैट मीन साइज ऑफ सैंपल इज एन एंड एन इज ग्रेटर देन 30, देन वी से दैट दिस इज द लार्ज सैंपल. For such sample, we apply Z-test. So Z-test are using, there are in fourth, we are using Z-test for testing the significance or single proportion. Testing of significance of difference of proportion, that means two proportion, two samples. Proportions, single proportion, double proportion. Third, testing of significance for single mean. Testing of significance for difference of mean. The four type of the uses in large sample test. That means Z-test. Z-test are using in four cases. First one is single proportion. Second one is difference of proportion. Third is single mean. And fourth is double mean. So now we discuss about now testing of significance for single proportion. That means this test is used to find the significant difference between proportion of the sample and the population. Sample and population proportions. Let x the number of successive n independent trial. Here n trials with constant probability p of success, and p is represent here probability of success for each trial. In every trial, so now expected value of x is np, which is represented by binomial distribution. Variance is npq and q is equal to 1 minus p, or 1 minus p probability of failure. If p is the probability of success, then q is the probability of failure. And small p, here small p used for proportions. That means x is the number of success in n trial. So x upon n, this is called the proportions p, small p. We can represent it by small p. And capital P is the probability of success in each trial. And q is the probability of failure. So expected value of this we can represent here x upon n proportion expected value, and this is equal to 1 upon n into expected value of x, and expected value of x is np. So expected value of proportion is probability of p. Similarly, we can find the variance of pq by n. Both all these value are used in test statistics. So we define before using the test statistics small p and capital P, expected value of p and variance of p. That means proportions, expected value and variance of proportions. So this is the test statistics which are used in questions. P minus expected value of P and standard error of P. These are the standard error. We already discussed about standard error. So these statistics, you have to remember this formula or Z test. Z is equal to small p minus expected value of P or divided by standard error of P. So this is the test statistics of Z in single proportion cases. Now we give an example of this single proportion. A coin was tossed 400 times. There are 400 times, n is 400, and the head turned up 216, and head is 216 times. The hypothesis that tests that the coin is unbiased. So first of all, after reading the statements, we can understand that there is n is equal to 400, that means greater than 30. So this is the large sample. So first of all, we take the large sample. So we use Z test, and head turn up 216 times. So coin is, we check the coin is biased or unbiased. The coin is unbiased. So first of all, we set up the H note. H note is a definite statement in favor of sample, and H note is set up that the coin is unbiased. So we check in the statement is unbiased, so we take H note in favor of sample. This is unbiased coin. H1 is coin is biased, or we can say that this is biased or coin is not unbiased. So these are the H note and H1, n is equal to this, and number of success is this. So proportion of successes, proportion is point x upon n, this is equal to 0.4. now p, here using these test statistics, this p is the proportion. Proportions mean 0.45, and capital P, expected value of p, this is equal to expected value of small p is equal to capital P, and capital P is the probability of success. Probability of success, and probability of success, success here is coin, when coin is tossed, the head turn up. Head turn up, this is the success. So we throw a coin, the probability of head is 1/2, that means 0.5. So this is equal to 0.5. And standard error means PQ upon N. Using this 0.5 into P, is probability of head is 0.5, and Q is equal to 1 minus P. So this is also 0.5. So using these, we find the value of Z statistics is 1.6. So 1.6, this is equal to calculated value. And we use two tail test, because we say that coin is unbiased, yani mu is equal to mu naught, that means. So we use two tail test. This is only calculated value 1.6. now we compare this calculated value through the tabulated value. If there are the significance level given in the questions, we check from the table. If there is no given, then we take 5% level of significance from our sides, always taking 5%. In the table, we use 5% level of value is compare with the calculated value. Calculated value compare with the tabulated value. Tabulated value is find from the table. So if calculated value is less than tabulated value, we accept the H note. If calculated value is greater than tabulated value, we accept the H1 and reject H note. So in these questions, there are tabulated value is 1.96 and calculated value is 1.6. So our calculated value is less than tabulated value. So we accept the H note, and here H note is coin is unbiased. So we say that the given coin is unbiased. This is the use of Z test in large sample for single mean, single proportions. So now in next, we use test of difference between proportions. There are two proportions, two samples. Here capital P is defined by this formula, small p1 and p2. p1 is proportion of first sample, p2 find the proportion of second sample. So we get the p, and after p we can find the q. Using this test statistics, we can find the Z test, calculated value of Z test. So in this through this example we can check the difference between two proportion and using these test statistics and finding the value and putting in this we get find the 6.842. these are the calculated value. If there are no significant level in this given questions, so we use 5% level of significant. So we can take here calculated value compare with the tabulated value, and here mod of z is calculated with both the significant value z at 5% and 1% level of significance. We take both two significant value, 5% and 1%, we have to check on both. Hence H naught is reject, there is a significant difference in consumption of tea due to increase the excise duty. So through this example we can say that use of Z test in two samples, that means difference of between proportions. Now use for single mean, test of significance for single mean when n is greater than 30, then Z statistics is x bar is the sample mean and mu is the population mean and sigma is the variance and n is the total number of trial. So these are the test statistics for single mean when n is greater than 30. This is the example of Z test when single mean. A normal population has a mean is 6.8 and standard deviation is 1.5. a sample of 400 members, that mean n is greater than 30, that mean we use the Z test, and Z statistics for single mean is x minus mu upon sigma upon root n. This is the test statistics which are used this. So putting all these value we can calculate the calculated value this, and now is the significant difference from these. We calculate the calculated value of these statistics is 0.67 and tabulated value at 5%. We always take 5% level of significance when no any level of significance given in the statement. We always take 5% level, and taking the tabulated value from this 1.96, this is called the and tabulated value, and we compare both tabulated and calculated. If calculated is greater than tabulated value, we reject H naught. If calculated is less than tabulated value, we accept H naught. So these are the two example of single mean. Similarly, we can test the significance for difference of means. Now difference of mean, already in before this we can check also difference of proportions, but there are difference of mean of two large sample. So Z statistics is x1 bar from the first mean, x2 bar is the mean of second sample, sigma 1 square is the variance of first mean, first sample, and sigma 2 square is the sample of variance of second sample. So putting all these value, these are the test statistics for difference of two means. This is the example. Through this example we can check the difference of two large sample, and we check the difference between their mean. So this is the Z test in testing of hypothesis.